Hello, 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 and welcome to Test Preparation 14. My name is Steve Ford, and today we have a special video. I have done some research, and I want to share my findings with you about in-depth similarities and differences between the TOEFL test and the IELTS academic test. So let's go. My first point has to do with levels of formality, and I would like you to imagine with me a pyramid of formality, where at the base of the pyramid, we have a semi-formal level of English. There is a commonality between the TOEFL and the IELTS, so I can't stress enough the importance of knowing phrasal verbs. So that means that you really have to be on the ball with your phrasal verbs. You have to be really on your toes. You need to brush up on your phrasal verbs. You need to know 2- and 3-part phrasal verbs. Also those phrasal verbs that can take an object between the preposition and the verb. Also the ones that can take an object after the preposition. There is a great variety of phrasal verbs. So, for those of you who are in doubt whether phrasal verbs are used in the TOEFL and IELTS academic test, now you know that they are for certain used in both. Warning: some phrasal verbs in the UK are different from phrasal verbs in the US. My second point has to do with the question format in both tests. This is where things start to vary. In the TOEFL, we have multiple choice questions. And it is a little deceptive because regardless of the fact that you just have multiple choice, many times those questions can be just as difficult because you can be between two questions. You can also be required to select 2 questions of the 4 or even do a task of 4 separate things in 1 question. So looks can be a little deceiving in that regard. When we move on to the IELTS academic, we can see that the test varies quite a bit. And we can see that people are required to fill out forms, they're required to fill out calendars, planners, lists, and they are required to write no more than 3 words. So with that test, you have to be really on your toes because you actually have to be writing out words. I have seen certain strategies suggested. You might want to follow them. For example, reading the questions before the listening occurs. Also, perhaps trying to take notes during the listening or trying to write the words as you hear them into the blanks. The choice is yours. My third point, comparing the TOEFL and the IELTS academic test, has to do with pronunciation. Now, I listened very carefully and I went through the scripts for listening sections 1 and 2 on the TOEFL. And what I found is that typical American mix of formal and semi-formal and academic all rolled into one. So you could have someone kind of, if you remember back to that pyramid, coming from a formal level and then kind of dipping down into the semi-formal and then maybe shooting back up again to the formal. So there is definitely a flexibility in the listening, and that can be reflected in the pronunciation, where perhaps they start out speaking like I am in this video, which is at a formal level, very clear and pronounced, as one fellow teacher told me, teacherese. And we could bring that down to the semi-formal level by saying, you know, I got a lot of things to do today. You can see that I can start to put all of those words together, kind of link them together. So you really have to be paying attention to that, because you never know when they're going to slip down into semi-formal mode. comparatively speaking, in the IELTS academic, what I found is that it is limited more to simple contractions, and I don't think it goes any further than that. Not as far as the TOEFL in terms of linking words together. That, for certain, has a lot to do with the difference between American and British English. The Americans do try to make a point of being a little bit more semi-formal, even in an academic setting. But it is just as much of an equal challenge when we are considering that in the IELTS academic, many times you will have background noise during the listening activities to give you that extra challenge. You will also have a wide variety of accents, given that we are now in a global village. Point number four has to do with numbers and dates. And this is a similarity with a capital S. In my investigations, I did careful observations of the TOEFL and IELTS academic. And when you consider that you are working under pressure, and you are also working with a hard drive, a biological hard drive, which I believe, and I think that probably this can be proven, many times our brain will skip forward a number. An example, if we see the number 4, many times we'll say the number 5. If we see a word, many times we will say a word closely associated with that word. So you really have to be on your toes in this section of the test. I'm sure that many native speakers would get the answers wrong on this part of the test because this section isn't necessarily testing your linguistic competence as much as it is your attention skills and logic. So you have to be a real left brainer to ace this part of the test. Warning, once again, there is a difference between the British, many times in terms of dates, they'll say June 5. The Americans would say June 5th, June 31, June 31st. That can be a point of confusion, and that's come up as a question many times with my advanced students. So think about that one. Now, point number 5 is where can you get some material online to start to practice this mix of semi-formal, formal English? And I think that probably one of the best would be a show called Parkinson. That's the host of the show, who is British, interviewing many times not only British people, but also American people, Hollywood stars. So I would highly recommend that because you can get a good mix of both kinds of English as well as different levels of formality. Now, I have made some sample listening activities for both the TOEFL and IELTS academic, which I will be posting on my website. I just finished those today, and I will be posting those for anybody that is signed up for free on my student community, Peppy Club. If you need more help, please contact me as I do give one-to-one preparation for people preparing to do the TOEFL and the IELTS academic test. Most commonly, we practice the listening, speaking, and writing sections. So, I hope that you are able to take advantage of all my information from my research, and I hope to see you on my student community. I hope to see you on my YouTube channel or on Facebook. We'll see you online. Bye-bye.
Well, I was walking down the street one day, I came across my mate, my friend, Mr. David. Well, he was speaking British English to me, we got on perfectly, my buddy, David. All the time he was spot on, I guess that's why we got along. We had a matter over tea and scones. It was June 21, that is to say June 21st. The sun was sun above my head. Well, I was walking down the street one day, I ran into my friend, my buddy, David. While he was chatting away with me, we got along perfectly, my colleague, David. All the time I was right on, and that's the reason we got on. We chatted over coffee with cream. Pretty soon it was midday, you can sail the other way. The summer sun above my head.